কনফার্ম ক্যামেরা, হোয়াট ইজ লাস্ট লেকচার? হ্যালো,
ব্লক ডায়াগ্রাম অফ N05-1।
yes, we have seen the 805 block diagram. After that, we have written some features of 805-1, and then we gone for the architecture diagram of 805-1. And in that, we have seen the first point in that there are different types of memories, and then PSW. What is the use of the PSW and how it will affect when the accumulator will perform some actions or task? Correct, na? Okay, chalo. Will tell me what are the features of 8051? Fast, in one stroke, will tell. Hello. Will you elaborate me what are the features of 8051? Things are too easy. What things were drawn in the diagram, block diagram or the architecture diagram? That is a feature of that particular 8051. So just we have to close your eyes and we can see that in the diagram what things are, what blocks are there, functional blocks. That will be the features of that. So I'll take the name today. So it is easy for all. Arti Bandgar. Again, you have changed your setting name, profile name. Arti is there? Arti Bandgar?
Yes.
Oh, why are you changing
your... I will change, sir.
Change it. Chalo, we'll ask Vagmode. 51, roll number 51. Vagmode Pratimesh. Hello. Vagmode, are you there? Roll number 51. Hello. Hello. Vagmode, is it audible to you? I'm audible to you. If not, I will remove you. You have to give the answer. Vagmode, roll number 51.
Yes, sir.
What I'm asking, what was my question?
Sir, repeat one second.
मग तुम्ही कुठे होता, मोबाईल ठेवून कुठे गेलता? मग क्वेश्चन नाही कळला.
सर आहे इथेच आहे.
मग असं कसं काय क्वेश्चन नाही का कळाला तुम्हाला? मी 3-4 वेळेस नाव कॉल केलेला आहे. ओके, चलो, लेट इट बी. What are the features of 8051? How will you describe it? In one stroke, you have to tell fast.
Yet nahi, sir.
Kaan yet nahi? This is, I'm not here to listen this answer. Yet nahi, sir. Whether you are there in for last lecture?
Yes, sir, I'm present.
And then, what is problem? Have you written the notes? Have you sent a screenshot of that?
No, sir.
Then, what is problem? Tumhala karayachi nahi ga sincerely?
करायचंय सर.
मग का पाठवत नाही तुम्ही स्क्रीनशॉट? तुम्हाला काही वेगळं ट्रीटमेंट पाहिजे का?
नाही सर.
मग मीन्स यू आर टेकन ग्रांटेड?
नो सर.
आय नीड टू टॉक विथ युअर पॅरेंट आहे ना, इफ यू आर डुईंग लाईक दिस. आय आस्क क्वेश्चन, व्हॉट आर द फीचर्स ऑफ 8051? यू आर रिप्लाईंग इमिडिएटली आय डोंट नो. व्हॉट इज मीनिंग ऑफ दिस? तुम्हाला करायचं नाही, तुम्हाला सांगायचं नाही का?
नाही सर.
वी आर हियर टू मेक द फन. असं काय आहे का तुम्हाला इंजिनिअरिंग करायचं आहे, काहीतरी कमवून दाखवायचं करायचं काय, असं काय आहे का? नाही
करायचं सर.
असं असं जर आन्सर सांगितलं कसं व्हायचं?
सॉरी सर.
देन टेल फीचर. What are the blocks are there in that? You can tell me. Then we'll go with the features. If you talk about block diagram of 8051, what are the different blocks are there in that block diagram? In one stroke, you have to tell all the blocks. Go ahead. Fast work mode, don't waste time. We should not waste time of other people. Will you switch on your camera, mobile camera? I'll ask randomly to make your camera on and let me see what you're doing there. Kuta hai tumi? Ghari datka? Ghari notebook? Show me.
Garmi jevan karte sir.
Jevan karta hai? Lecturing karta hai?
Haan sir.
Why? You should take before the lecture and when the break of the leg that. During the lecture, while taking the lunch, show me your notebook. Where is the notebook?
Sir, no, get liye nahi hai sir notebook.
Then we people are mad. You are asking that can send the screenshot and show me notebook. At the first lecture, I talk about that. I should prepare the separate notebook for that.
Sir, made butter now for eating, so I not taken the notebook.
Any. That is what we are doing that I'm asking here. My lecture is going on. When my lecture is going on, what things are I told? You should take it, na?
Yes, sir.
I'll remove you from the class and you take lunch for 2 hours, no issue. Huh?
No, sir.
Then what is use of that, na? You're making fun of the lectures. Oh, keeping the mobile on some table and doing your task and what things are it is asked. You're directly telling that I don't know, sir. Means what it indicates. You don't want to do the things either, but just make the fun of that.
Sorry, sir.
Earlier I talked about, I don't want any kind of excuse. Mala sorry mala chalat nahi koni bilkul chalat nahi hai. I'm not here to listen the sorry from you people. I'm here to make the people, you should write and you should learn about some new technology, new things about that. Wasting like this every time 10-15 minutes to teach you how to attend the class, how to write the things. तुम्ही आता एवढं मॅच्युअर झाला टीवाय ला आहे म्हणजे तुम्ही खूप मॅच्युअर आहात. एका वर्षात इंदिरा बाहेर पडणार आहात तुम्ही आणि कंपनीला असं करणार आहेत का तुम्ही? जॉबच करायचं नाही. चेंज युअर ऍटिट्यूड, इट इज टोटली रॉंग थिंग.
सॉरी सर, नेक्स्ट टाइम नाही होणार सर.
ते लंच बंद करा, लेक्चर अटेंड करा. नोट आज काय झालं मला नोट करायचं. आफ्टर दिस लेक्चर इन द ब्रेक यू शुड कॉल मी. आय विल टॉक विथ युअर पॅरेंट.
येस सर.
हा, पॅरेंटला कॉल करून द्यायचं मला. चलो क्लोज युअर स्विच ऑफ युअर माय कॅमेरा. चलो हुल टेल मी, कोण सांगते मला फीचर्स? इट्स टू इझी. शुड आय टेल फर्स्ट हाऊ टू टेल द आन्सर ऑफ दॅट? असं कोणाला वाटतं का मी सांगावं? कृष्णा, what do you feel?
Yes, sir.
सांगताय का आन्सर? मी सांगू द्या पहिल्यांदा कसं सांगायचं ते.
As your wish, sir. If you want to listen from us, we will tell. Otherwise,
I am eager to listen from the Krishna.
Okay, sir. I will tell.
Your name is Krishna. I am a fan of the Krishna.
Okay, sir.
Chalo, tell. Yes, yes. Go ahead, fast.
Features of 8051, it consists of 8-bit data bus and 8-bit ALU, that
ALU.
Arithmetic and logical unit.
Yes.
And 6-bit address bus.
There
is on chip RAM. What, sir?
Address bus size, how much?
16-bit.
16-bit, correct. Huh? I heard
on chip. On-chip RAM is 128 bytes, and on chip ROM is 4 kilobytes.
Mm-hmm.
There are two timers and one serial port. There are totally 4 ports, port 0, port 1, port 2, and port 3.
Mm.
I will tell this only, sir.
Okay, good. That is also sufficient. What are the major parts are there? You can tell it is good. You are missing with the interrupts only. And 5 different types of interrupts are there, int 0, int 1, then DI, and the timer 0, timer 1. That is okay, good. Means you are doing something. Who else will tell in one stroke? What are the functional blocks are there in the architecture diagram? Girl side, anybody? And today's strength is very less, 34 are there. What about other students? What are you doing? What function is there? What? Mahesh?
No, sir, no.
Then why the students are not there? Only 34 are there. Some are joining now. Shivraj Nimbalkar. Shivraj Nimbalkar is there? Why are you late? Shivraj, are you listening? Hello. Shivraj, are you listening or not? It is 43 roll number. Again, he left, I think he is not there. Chalo, who will tell from girl side? I want one question answered fast. Without wasting time. No one from the girl side? Hello. Atkali, is there Atkali? Number one. Atkali, she is not there. She is not there. Aarti Bandgar?
Yes, sir.
Will you tell what are the blocks are there in the architecture diagram? Architecture of the 8051, what are the blocks are there? Not sequentially. How you are remembered, you can tell. So it's easy for understanding. Santail? So now, how to remember? Why I'm investing time in that? Because when the questions are asking block diagram draw kara or architecture diagram draw kara for 4 or 6 months, it is asking. You should remember the blocks at least. What are the blocks are in that? Okay, and when the see the actual parts of that, how it is connected to the database, and that is, but you'll understand that, and you have to connect that particular block to the that address and the database. Okay, starting with, we know that what it had, the 4 ports are there. Okay, port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3. So port 0 and port 2, it is on the top side of that diagram. You can look on your diagram, you'll understand that. Okay, so port P0.0 to P0.7. That port is zero for following the port 0 and the driver. Below that, exactly internally, we are connecting with the latch of the port 0. Okay, so nearby that, it has the port 2 driver and the port 0 or port 2 latch. Okay, so after that, in the below that, we have the different 5 blocks are there, starting with the RAM memory address register. Then the RAM is a RAM block is there, 128 byte. Then we have the in that latch for the port 0 and the latch for port 2 along with that. And then we have the flash memory that is called as a ROM memory of the 8051. That ROM memory belongs to the that is 4 kilobyte on chip RAM ROM is there. Okay, then exactly below that we have the different registers are there, starting with the left to the right side. We have the first register B is there. Okay, it is like a temporary register, like a simple A, that is called as a B register. Then we have the parallel to that, that is called as the A register or the accumulator of the size 8 bit. Then below that we have the that A register is connected to the ALU unit. Okay, that is called as arithmetic and logic unit, and most of the task is carried out in that ALU unit, and the results are floating in the either in the internal RAM memory or the in the external memory, which is going to be interfaced. Okay, and exactly below that we have the PSW register, and we've seen that based on the ALU operation performs, what are the flags will be affected. As you know that when we do the addition, and if a simple example I taken yesterday, 1 3 10 0 1 3 10 0, we're adding with the same data at exactly when the 8 bit will be addition, we are getting the carry. Okay, but we are understanding, we people have the memory that the brain is there, we're understanding, we have learn about that when the at the MSB bit we are adding, that 1 plus 1 x or 0 becomes 1 carry will be there. But how that control understand that when the data is giving like this, okay, so that we are given the separate registers and we can check the status of that result in that PSW, that is called a program status word register. Okay, to parallel to that we have the next is going to be stack pointer and then various controlling register, that starting with the program address register, then we have the buffer, program counter, incrementer and the program counter. And below that we have the buffer and the most important DPTR. DPTR is called as a the data pointer register, and that is used for exactly for accessing the external memories. So it has again two things in that register, divide in that DPH and DPL. DPH is for taking the higher data, okay, and DPL is for the lower data. And DPH and DPL is actually of 8 bit. If you combine that, it becomes 16 bit data can be taken in that. And exactly below that, at the bottom of that diagram, we have seen that we have the port 1 and the port 3. Okay. And aside from that, we have the crystal connector and the various control pins are there. That is the ALE, PSNW bar, and then ALE bar, along with that, reset and the EA bar. And in that, the things are connected to the controller, timing and control signals and the instruction registers. Okay, so these are the functional blocks, how they're connected, how based on that the our controller 805 is going to be operated. Is it clear everyone, you know how to remember the blocks in that? Hello
Yes sir.
Okay, the same diagram it is shown here, the things we have just repeated. Please try to look, things is very important. If I ask you what are the features of certain people, if you're number one, number two, anything, I don't know the exact names, how to talk the features of that means what? Appearance, how it looks. Okay, so in the diagram, if you talk about IC diagram, what are the internal things are there that become the feature of that particular IC? So I can say from this also I can write the features of 8051, starting with what? I know its size is going to 8 bit. ALUs of 8 bit means what? It is 8 bit microcontroller. Okay, along with this it has A register, that is accumulator of 8 bit. Then we have the B register of the 8 bit, that is for temp register. Then ALU performs the arithmetic logic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, along with that logical operations, XOR, OR, like that. Okay, and the results are going to always going to be impact on that effect, and it is checked in the program status registers. Okay, then it has the internal RAM of 128 byte, then it has the ROM. Are you getting the difference between the flash and the ROM? What is the flash and the ROM? Do you know the difference? Tumhala mahit aahe ka flash ka aste ROM ka aste?
ROM, sir, ROM.
Okay, ROM and flash are both are the same? Are they different?
I don't know, sir, but I know about ROM.
Oh, no, you shouldn't add. Now you talk about her. What is ROM?
ROM is a memory processing.
Okay, ROM is a memory processing. Again, what else? Okay, so ROM is called as a what? A read-only memory. Okay, it becomes only read-only memory. So we have the starting, ROM is called as a program memory. Okay, so here I am storing the code of the data. What are the program I am writing? I am storing all within the that ROM memory. Previously, when it invented, we have the permanent memory, read-only memory is called as a ROM. Then we have the PROM. PROM is what? Programmable read-only memory. Then we have the EPROM, erasable programmable read-only memory. So I'll take this slide so you'll understand here. Ek blank slide give to me. Okay, starting with what? ROM. ROM is what? Read-only memory. Okay, it is important. You might learn in the DTS, na? Correct, na? Mem, I'll take mem. Okay, then we how the flash is invented. I am talking about data. Then we have the PROM. Audible? Oh, is my voice audible? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then we after the ROM, the things invented is called as a PROM. PROM is called as a programmable. Not programmable. Read-only memory. That is ROM. Okay. Then we have the EPROM. So what is EPROM? Just advanced version of the PROM memory. So erasable. Erasable. Program memory, that is PROM, I can say. Then we have the E-square PROM, means EE PROM, also called as the E-square PROM. What is the meaning of that? Electrically so you can take somewhere in that notebook also in para to understand that electrically erasable PROM memory, correct? And then I have the flash memory. So what is the meaning of this? When the things are invented, starting with the ROM memory, means read only memory. So in that I can read only one times in that. Okay, then I the things are scientists are invented at the PROM, means I can program that memory. So program means what? In the same memory, how many times I code can be burn out? Nearly 10 times, 15 times can be same code can be burned out in that IC or memory. That is called as a PROM memory. Then we have the erasable PROM. So near about 10 to 15 times, 50 times I can write the same code in the same memory. After that, it is going to be vanishes. That is called as a EPROM memory, erasable PROM memory. Then we have the electrically erasable. Nearly 100 times, 200 times I can write the same code in the memory. Same code means what? The process is there. Once we write the code, project code, we are burning that code into the that program memory always. Program means what? Either ROM, PROM, EPROM, E-square PROM, or the flash. Okay. So how many times same in the same IC control we have taken? How many times I can write the code in that memory? That depends upon the these memories. Either ROM, PROM, EPROM, E-square PROM, or the flash. Nowadays, all the IC mostly along with the flash memory only. So flash, this is 100, 200 times you can write the same code, burn code in the memory. But in the flash, 1,000 times can be code can be burned in the or control IC. That is a flash memory. Means all the flash, EPROM, all the categories of the code program memory or the code memory or the ROM memory only. Clear now? Kalata?
Yes, sir.
Have you taken this?
Yes, sir.
So what is flash? I can say that flash means when the ultraviolet will be put on that memory inside we insert. Ultimately, what are the data is stored? It vanishes and the read data can be written into that memory, and that becomes always it will be read when the control will start. That is meaning of the read only memory or the flash memory. Just only what number of times what is the data I return, it is going to be increases in the flash memory. Okay, have you taken this somewhere?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So do not forget now this part. Then we have seen this part also, 4K internal RAM memory, then 128 byte of RAM memory starting with address. MCQ is asking, yes, I'm repeating points of where I'm pointing. MCQ means now we may have the online offline exam. The size of the RAM in the 8051 is a 4 kilobyte, and the starting address from 00 to the maximum how much? So we should understand 4K means what? This means address 0 to 3 times of F. So always we should write in the paragraph MCQ. When you're reading the notebook, we should understand that what type of question is asking in the exam. Okay. Then we talk about accumulator 8-bit is there, AB registers are there used for the performing arithmetic operations, all these things. Then we have seen about PSW and we written this. Actually, I told to take the screenshot, but maximum students have sent the screenshot of this also, and some of only for the arcade diagram of the 8051. Those are missing that to take this program status word. Please take it, draw it, everyone. So this register is always used to when we are performing the arithmetic logical operations, and when the data will be exceeded, what are the results will be affect. We can check it in the program status register. Okay, so it will have the starting with the bit will go to zero. Parity flag, P stands for the parity. So it will indicate that what is the data I'm taking. It may be data hex data which I'm taking in that. So that data having how many number of ones. If it is a even number of ones, that becomes even parity. So this bit will be zero. Okay, if the data consists of odd number of ones, that becomes odd parity. And when odd parity will come, this flag will be set here by one. Okay, this is not used. This is overflow flag. Overflow means what? When I'm accessing the if we talk about a register, this 8-bit, and when I'm to access the data greater than that, 16-bit, that will show that it is a overflow. Okay, so and when this things happens, automatically this bit will be set. So understand that incoming data is greater than the size of the actual register. Then we have the bit number 3, 4, 5 bit number is for the selection of the register bank. As I said that RAM internally we have the 4 different banks are there for selection of registers, that is general purpose register R0 to R7. Okay, so when this bit will be 00, that becomes register bank 0. When this bit will be 01, bank 1, 10, bank 2, and when it is 11, bank 3. And for address also given for that, in the bank 0 will be there, 0 to 7. 8 bit is there, each bank. Excuse me. Each bank is for the 8 bit. 0, 0 to 7 means it is 8 bit. Okay, then second bank is from 8 to F. That will be along with the 8 plus 8, 16 bit will be there. F means 16 bit. Okay. Then we have the additional bank 2 for the 8-bit and last bank for the 32-bit. That will start with that is 18 to 1F. So understand that this address is required to understand which bank I'm using and how to use that internal RAM by checking the disk contents. Okay. Then we have, we talk about architecture diagram. We have the internally stack pointer, as I said that. What is the stack pointer? Stack means what? Will tell me meaning of stack. Stack means what? Have you seen the stack for the keeping the shoes here? Shoes or the bags we are keeping in the colleges. Normally called as a rack, shoe rack or shoe stand. Correct? Bagitla Sarvandi? Hello? Hello, have you seen this? Shoe stand, bagatla sarvandi, shoe stand. Hello, voice is audible?
Yes, sir. Yes.
I'm asking simple question, what? Have you seen the shoe stand or the, in the college, if you talk about CAD 2 lab, we have the keeping the bags, the rack is there. Okay, so same thing is there, stack pointer. It is a 16-bit register usually in the or a controller. Why this stack pointer is required? As I said, that when the interrupt is occurred, okay, that time we are keeping the memory location of the program counter in that stack register, and we are going for the ISR execution. Once ISR will be comes back, completed the execution, we comes to the protocol address. Now, why this process is required? Now understand that you are going for some unknown address. Okay. If you talk about your natives and you're from the native, you are going to some unknown location from you. Always while walking from the road, always you are looking at the side by shops or that to remember the address while I'm returning back to that. But again, आपण कुठं गेल्यानंतर आपण काय करतो, एक पर्टिक्युलर लोकेशन आपण आयडेंटिफाय करतो की ह्या लोकेशन मी आलतो असं जायचं आपण महागारी, करेक्ट ना? अननोन प्लेस गेल्यानंतर आपण असं करतो का नाही?
येस सर,
करेक्ट ना? ना कंट्रोलर आहे, त्या कंट्रोलर कसं करणार बाबा काय चालू आहे कसं करायचं आहे मला, नाही करणार ना. सो देर इज मेकॅनिझम फॉर दॅट. ओके, सिम्पल गोष्ट आहे, कंट्रोल इज गोइंग एक्झिक्युट दिस परफॉर्मिंग द ऍडिशन ऑफ द 2-bit नंबर्स. ओके, अँड व्हाइल परफॉर्मिंग ऍडिशन द इंटरप्ट ऑकर्स. When interrupt occurs, what is the meaning of that? That controller want to suspend the what was the task going on program 8051 addition thambai jitala. Correct. When addition thambur kai karayche tala, he want to go for the next program. So that what was the previous memory location was there, it will keep in the stack pointer, and it will go for the what was the interrupt task, and what was the interrupt task is there, it will be completed. Means we are performing the simple different tasks. Means LED blinking sa program to run karte. Okay, once LED blinking program will be run for some time duration, it comes back. But tala mahar kute yacha kasa kalnar, kalna paije ka tala? So that it check the what was the address stored in the stack pointer, and from that address only memory location start the remaining program execution. That is that for that purpose only the stack pointer is required. And so we have the instruction, that is push and the call, to access and the keep the data in the stack pointer. Clear now? Kalna tha stack pointer to use? Hello, have you got the meaning of stack pointer?
Yes sir, yes.
Okay, so take this point, stack pointer. And based on this, MCQ is asking when the reset condition, what is the address of stack pointer will be initialized. What is Kyle as of Malang Kalneta? Move this window. Nothing happening on that. Return simple stack pointer काय दिलेला? Write these two lines only. It contains the address of the data item in the top of the stack. And on a reset condition, SP becomes initialized to the address 07H hexadecimal value. Make it fast. Additionally, I will tell below that these two sentences are over. Up to on reset condition.
Yes, sir. Over.
Okay. Below that, write down one more line. Stack pointer is used for storing the temporary. Stack pointer is used for storing the temporary. Stack pointer is used for storing the temporary address of the program counter. Storing the address of the program counter when interrupt occurs. Store the address. Address means what? Always try to remember. Address means what? I'm pointing memory location. Data value. Okay, it is 8 bit and memory location 16 bit always as a address bus is size of 16 bit. Address means in bracket you can write memory location. Store the temporary address in bracket memory location of the program counter when interrupt occurs. Written, completed?
Yes, sir.
Okay, full stop. Once interrupt is completed, once interrupt is completed, microcontroller, we can add mu and c shortcut. Mu c means microcontroller. Once interrupt is completed, microcontroller resumes execution. Once interrupt is completed, microcontroller resumes program task, which is kya hai the program means it may be 8 bit addition, 16 bit subtraction, resumes program from the memory location stored in the stack. From the memory location stored in the stack. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then next register, we have the data pointer that is called a DPTR. And as I said that while explaining, it has the two register, that is DPH and DPL, of each size 8 bit, that will form with the 16 bit data register. And this DP pointer, always data pointer, I'm always using to access the memory location, which may be either external or it may be internal. Okay, that is function of the data pointer. It indicates name itself, data point, right? Points memory location. It points always memory location. It may be the internal, it may be the external. Write down data pointer. So we can take the what are the contents stored in the external data memory using the DPTR register, like simple move DPTR comma address. When we go with the instruction, we'll understand that part. Write things about the data pointer immediately. Shortly also we can write down DPH, DPL of each size 8 bit, either higher and lower bytes, and it is size, total size is 16 bit, either for accessing the either internal or external memories, memory location, or external data memory. Over. Over.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Over.
Okay. So next register is there. That is all SFRs. Next is called as a program counter, PC. If we talk about embedded system, the R15 register is there. That forms the program counter. So counter means what? Count the value, it's going to be increment. So the program counter always indicates the address of the next memory location or the address of the next instruction. Means what is address shown in the program counter controller or ALU performs the operation from that memory address itself. That is function of the program counter. Is it simply what indicator for the controller from which address I should start the program? It depends upon what are the contents stored in 16-bit memory address stored in the program counter. Clear? Colors around a program counter. It shows the always address of the next instruction to be executed. And it's going to be incremented by one of each task. Right on program counter, 16-bit wide, and it holds the address of the next instruction to be executed. So while performing some programs on the KL software, we'll see about that program counter context, how it will be incremented after execution of each instruction. Done? Hello?
Yes.
Read about this also. On reset condition, PC will set to 00. When we press the button, the reset pin is there for the 8051. When we press the reset button, our failure is there. The reset button will be pressed automatically. It contents will go to the 0000. And once this instruction is executed from the memory address something, next time PC automatically going to be incremented by one. That is function of PC. MCQ is always asking on this SFRs. But next point, address bus. So address bus, what it says, 16-bit address bus is there. That indicates 2 raised to 16 means that number of memory location can be used. And what is function of address bus? Always it is used to carry the or goes to the particular memory location and can access the data from that memory location. So if you talk about externally interface the memory location to the 8051. I want to access the data from that memory location. Address bus is used to access the data from that. And from internal registers, directly data bus can be connected. This is the difference between the data bus and the address bus. Done this address bus. Just write this 16-bit wide and used to access the data from the external or internal memory location. Then write down. Interrupts, write down. Next point, we have the block that is called the interrupts. Hello. Have you written the point interrupts?
Yes.
Okay. What is the definition of interrupt? Will you tell me? We have seen this also. While seeing the first chapter, what is interrupt? So from my side, some power failure is there. So we may lost the connections, but be there in the lecture. Once it will be resumed, I will be come back. Okay. What is interrupt? Full tell. So I can say that now what is the power failure is there. It is kind of interrupt for our lecture also. Correct? So how to define interrupt definition? विसरला का तुम्ही लगेच फर्स्ट लेक्चर मी सांगितलेला आहे फर्स्ट चॅप्टर मध्ये. हॅलो कोण सांगताय फुल टेल? इंटरप्ट इज अ सिग्नल. ओके इट इज अ काइंड ऑफ सिग्नल विच टेक्स द अटेंशन ऑफ 8051 एंड बेस्ड ऑन द प्रायोरिटी इट इज हाई प्रायोरिटी इट सस्पेंड द current task and goes for the what was the task what was interrupted. A simple example from me, we are performing the 8051 addition program, okay, and externally I'm connecting the push button to certain port. Okay, I can say port 0.0 like push button lavalla ahe, and while performing addition it displays on the LCD and I'm at the same time I'm pressing the push button. Control, what will take the control action?